Ryan Thomas of EastWest here, and welcome to the walkthrough of our brand new comedy expansion for Hollywood Orchestrator. Now, this preset package was designed to cover as much ground as possible, so it features presets ideal for everything from dark, quirky comedies to rom-coms, and even Christmas movies like the preset you just heard. So I want to go ahead and jump into these as quickly as possible, but first, let's very briefly talk about how to install and use these new presets. So the first thing you'll need to do is install the Hollywood Orchestrator update from the Installation Center. So just run that and the presets will automatically be installed. Then in Opus, all you have to do to find the presets is open up Orchestrator, navigate to the presets by clicking on this bar, go over to the Scores section, and you'll find the various themes in the Category column and the individual presets in the Presets column. Then just double-click on the preset you want to load. So let's go ahead and check out our first theme, which is Christmas comedy. The Christmas comedy presets were designed for pretty much all things related to the holidays, with a focus, of course, on scoring material that tends to be more light and funny. So the preset that you heard at the very beginning of this video was Christmas Comedy 01. So let's go ahead and move on to Christmas Comedy 2, which you can kind of think of as a B section to Christmas Comedy 1. So those two presets might be ideal for the opening to one of these kinds of movies where you really need to spin up the excitement and set the tone for the rest of the film. Now, the next preset is Christmas Comedy 03, and this one is going to tone things down a bit, so it might be ideal for a scene where a character is sneaking around or otherwise is up to something. Next up is Christmas Comedy 04, and this one has kind of a quirky energy to it, so it might be good for a scene where there's definitely a comedy element, but also just a little bit of action and maybe some suspense. All right, now we're into the 3-4 presets. And Christmas Comedy 05 is just generally kind of lighthearted and fun, and it happens to work really well with both major and minor chords. So this one's definitely effective with simple triads, but then you can throw in a sharp 11 to make it sound a bit more goofy and kind of whimsical. So there's a lot you can do with this one. Okay, next up is Christmas Comedy 06, and this one is kind of a companion to the previous preset. You can use these together to keep the same feel going, but vary the orchestration up a little bit. It keeps things more interesting, and it allows you to get more mileage out of both of these presets. So here's Christmas Comedy 06. So those are all of the Christmas comedy presets. Let's go ahead and move on to the next theme, which is cartoon antics. So cartoon antics is designed for comedy scenes in animated films and TV shows, and we tried to cover as much ground as possible. So you've got faster-paced presets that are ideal for sort of a comedy action scene like Cartoon Antics 04. And then you've got some slightly darker, more sparse presets like Cartoon Antics 02. Now, Cartoon Antics 01 is pretty middle of the road. It's got a nice energy to it, and it's just kind of quirky in general. And then Cartoon Antics 03 definitely has more of a comedy suspense feel to it. I think because it's got these string sustains that add just a bit of tension along with a vibraphone that just kind of darkens things up a little bit. And then finally, we've got Cartoon Antics 5 and 6. And these are both going to be in 3-4. They are fairly light, and I think they're ideal for just general-purpose comedy underscore. So, much like with some of the other presets, these two are also designed to be used with each other. So here's Cartoon Antics 05. That one is just so much fun to play. You can get a lot of mileage out of it, and it works really well with those diminished chords, those minor six chords, and of course, augmented chords. So here is Cartoon Antics 06. So you can just have a lot of fun with those two. I think they are super versatile, especially when you use them together. So that's it for Cartoon Antics. Let's go ahead and move on to the RomCom presets. Now, these were, of course, designed for romantic comedies. So they're going to be on the lighter side, they're pretty fun, and they work well with simpler chord structures. And the first two are actually in 6-8, so they have some movement to them, which gives them kind of an energetic, anticipatory feel. So these might be ideal for an intro scene, or maybe even a scene transition, or something along those lines. So here is the first one. And then here is RomCom 02, which is basically like the B section to RomCom 01. So we're keeping a similar feel, but switching up the orchestration just a bit. Here's RomCom 03, and this one is sort of medium-paced. It still has a bouncy energy to it, and it might be ideal for a scene where two characters are having some playful banter, maybe even while walking. For some reason, I think I associate movement with this preset. Now, RomCom 04 is ever so slightly darker than 03. So it takes on more of an adversarial feel, and it's ideal for those lighthearted verbal sparring matches that you often see in rom-coms. And it also works really well with RomCom 03. So very quickly, I want to show you how you can use these two presets to write an entire cue in just a couple minutes. And we're going to start with what I just played in RomCom 03, and we're going to follow that up with a phrase from RomCom 04. All right, now let's go ahead and add an English horn just to throw something a little bit different into the mix. So we're going to start this at measure 170. All right, now let's go ahead and add a line in the violins, and we're gonna start it right after that English horn solo. So it doesn't have to be anything super complicated. As you heard, that was a very simple line. And let's go ahead and copy and paste this down into the second violins. And then we're just going to lower it by an octave. And finally, let's add a cymbal scratch between RomComs 03 and 04, just to kind of glue those two phrases together. I think that timing was pretty much right on. Let's hear that one more time. I think that works. All right, let's go ahead and hear it all together from the beginning. So that is the power of Hollywood Orchestrator. It just allows you to cover so much ground so quickly, and it's perfect, of course, if you're on tight deadlines or if you just need a little bit of inspiration. So let's go ahead and move on to RomCom 05, and this one is in 3/4. It has a very slightly suspenseful feel to it. Of course, it's still a comedy preset. I might even call it more anticipatory than suspenseful. And then our last preset in this theme is RomCom 06. It's going to keep a fairly similar feel to the previous preset, but it has just a little bit more energy to it. So that's all for RomCom. Let's go ahead and take a look at our last theme, which is dark comedy. I had so much fun with the presets in the dark comedy theme, And these are all kind of centered around that Tim Burton slash Danny Elfman, very dark, quirky aesthetic. So let's go ahead and start off with Dark Comedy 01. And this one is very fast-paced and energetic. And then we have Dark Comedy 02, which is basically a variation of Dark Comedy 01. Now, Dark Comedy 3 and 4 also work really well together, and these are going to be in 3-4. So here's Dark Comedy 3. And this is Dark Comedy 04. So what I really like about these two is that they are fairly densely orchestrated, but they still retain that very light and unobtrusive quality that makes them ideal for a variety of different contexts, including underneath dialogue, which I think is really important for a lot of these comedy presets to be able to do. So I think these ones are very versatile. Now, Dark Comedy 5 and 6 are both going to be in 6-8, and they have a really fun swing element to them. And finally, here is Dark Comedy 06. So there's just so much that you can do with these. They are massively versatile, and I think they're just a great example of how powerful and flexible both the Hollywood Orchestrator engine and the Opus Player are in general. So if you already own Hollywood Orchestra Opus Edition, which includes Orchestrator, then these presets will automatically be installed in the next update. And if you don't, then I highly recommend either purchasing Hollywood Orchestra Opus Edition, or better yet, just becoming a Composer Cloud Plus subscriber, which then gives you access to every single instrument in the EastWest catalog, including Orchestrator. So if you liked this content, don't forget to like the video, comment on it, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future releases. That's all for now. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.